complex load. This fellow is a complex load and this fellow is a purely resistive fellow. This fellow has got a reactance part. You have to match a reactance with the resistive gain. Now, as you said, upper transformation is what?
CL.
Upper transformation is CL. What circuit we are following? LC, right? I'm sorry, low pass. Right. So, how do you introvert low pass circuit? C? Right. Is this circuit okay, da? Now it's okay? Hey, yes or no, da? Right, what is this fellow? This fellow is C. This fellow is? L. What is this fellow? 50. This fellow is? Minus. Let me tell you how to handle this minus J25 at the last moment. For the time being, let's consider it to be 50. So this is the first step, right? What is the second step? What is the second step? I'm sorry? Yes. How do you do it? What is RP? RP is? 500. Perfect. What is RS? RS is? 50. Am I right? So what is Q? Q is equal to root of RP by RS minus 1. So this is 500 by 50. 10 minus 1 is what? Root 9. Q is? 3. Am I right? Q is? 3. What is the next step we will have to follow? What is the step 3? What is step 3?
Convert
the parallel circuit to series circuit. Am I right? Series circuit to parallel. This one is a series parallel. So we need to convert it to parallel. How do I do it? This guy is CP. Am I right? Yes or no? How do I turn the CP and LP? And what is the state? 50. R is 50. Now tell me, how do you find LP? LP is equal to, what is the Q? LP is equal to RP divided by? Okay, tell me now, what is the Q factor for a parallel circuit?
Omega naught.
Omega naught?
Q.
Omega naught?
Q.
Am I right? What was the equation number from? We have named it right. I think it's equation number 1 or 2. Equation number? 1, na? 1, yeah. Equation 1. So LP is equal to RP by omega naught Q. Is it okay? Now can I find LP? Hey, yes or no? Tell me what is LP value, what is RP? RP is what? 50. Omega naught is 2, pi. F is what? Omega naught is what?
RP.
Oh sorry, RP is 500, yeah. What is omega naught? F is what? 2.4 into 10 power 9. And what is Q? 3. Tell me what is LP? 15? 22.1 nano? Parallel. Come on, do it and help me. LP, ma, it's not parallel, it's Henry. What do you get? 1 point? What do you get, Ra? Is it okay? Right. What is the next step? What we need to find out? CP. We need to compute what is?
CP.
So what is CP? CP is equal to 1 over omega naught square LP. CP is equal to 1 over omega naught square LP. Tell me what is the value of CP? Oh,
15.
What is CP?
0.40.
Sorry?
39.7.
Because of that, all of you getting it? All of you getting it? 39.7 picofarad. Is it okay? Hey guys, is it okay? No, no. Had it been only 50 ohms, our problem is solved. Had it been 50 ohms, our problem is solved. But what is the problem? We have 50 ohms minus J25. We have 50 ohms minus J25. Now what we have to do is we have to do another step. Step 5, let me call it as step 5. Right, none of you. I am drawing the circuit. What is this value? See? What is this value of capacitance? 39.7 picofarad. What is this inductance value? 11.05 nanohenry. Am I right now? Hey, yes or no? Yes? 0.39 picofarad. 0.39 picofarad. Okay, 0.39 picofarad. 0.39. Is it okay? No, listen here. That other, listen here, you can do the calculations later. Shreya, listen here. Now tell me, this is minus J25. Minus J25. Is it a capacitive load or an inductive load? Is it a capacitive load or an inductive load? Minus J25. Is it capacitive or inductive?
Capacitive.
It is capacitive in nature. Am I right?
Yes.
Yes.
So what is this fellow? This fellow is J25. This fellow is J25. Right? So it goes like this. Now tell me, what does this J25 mean? What does this J25 mean? C is equal to what? I told you reactance yesterday. I told you what is C is equal to in terms of reactance. C is equal to what? Reactance. 1 over omega C. It is nothing but 1 over omega C. I'm sorry? XC. XC is 1 over omega C. That is what capacitance is minus. Minus is here, right? Minus J25. Hey, S1 noda. I've written it there. Right? So this is equal to 1 over omega C. What is XC value? 25. XC value is 25. 1 over 2 pi F into C. Tell me what is C value. Tell me what is C value. What is F?
2.4.
What is it? 2.4 into 10 power 9 into C. Tell me what is the value of C? 2.6? Okay. This is 2.6 picofarad. Am I right? The C is nothing but 2.6 picofarad. Hey, am I right now? Hey, this is not the capacitance value. This is the reactance value. This is the reactance value. So we need to find out the capacitance. What is capacitance value? Capacitance is nothing but 2.6 picofarad. Now listen here. This is nothing but 2.6 picofarad. See, listen here. Last single step, you should pay attention. Just listen to the single part. There is a capacitive value here. Am I right? There is a capacitive value here. That has to be compensated. This fellow is in parallel with this gate. Am I right?
Yes.
This fellow is in parallel with this gate. Add this capacitance value here so that this fellow will compensate this gate. Am I right? Add this capacitance value here so that this fellow will compensate this gate. So what will be the new value of this fellow? Step 6. See? What is this fellow? 11.05 nanohenry. This is 50 ohms. That is the capacitive value here. 2.6 picofarad. These two products are in series or in parallel? These two products are in series or in parallel?
Parallel.
Parallel. Sorry, if you need to add capacitance in parallel, how do you do it? C is equal to C1 plus C2. C is equal to C1 plus C2. What is C1? 0.39 picofarad. What is C2? 2.6 picofarad. Right. What is this value? 2.99 picofarad. 2.99 picofarad. So there is a capacitance here that is compensated by increasing the capacitance value here. You understand? There is a capacitance value here that is compensated by increasing the capacitance value here. So 2.96 picofarad. So with this, this will be your impedance matching circuit. This will be your impedance matching circuit. Why I have added these two capacitance values? Because they are in parallel. If they were in series, what you suppose to do? You will have to do C is equal to C1, C2 by C1 plus C2. Is it okay? Okay, yes or no? You will follow the same procedure till here. For an upward transformation, you will do the same procedure till this point. In step 5, because it is given J25, 50 minus J25, so what is minus J25? It is capacitance. Minus J25 is nothing but capacitance. So yeah, the reactance of the capacitance value. The reactance of the capacitance. So J25 can be XC is nothing but 25. XC is nothing but 25. Minus 1 over omega C, minus the integer, for example. That minus is only here. Right? So 1 by 2 pi F into C. 1 by 2 pi F into C. From this you calculate the value of C. Now this is the capacitance value that is available here. This is the capacitance value that is available. How you will be compensated? By adding the capacitance here. By adding the capacitance here, you will be able to compensate. Is it okay? So that is your impedance matching circuit for complex loads. Impedance matching circuit for complex loads. You will have two steps extra. Is it okay, Doc? Design a LC lumped impedance matching circuit to match a load of 10 plus J10 ohms to a 50 ohm transmission line at 1 GHz frequency. At 1 GHz frequency. Suppose if they forget to give you the frequency, what happens? Can you do impedance matching? That means the problem is wrong. Am I right, Doc? Only at resonance you can do impedance matching. So yeah, they will definitely give you the frequency. So yeah, if they forget to give you the frequency, you assign some or assume some frequency. Say at design it at 2.4 GHz or 1 GHz, whatever you feel, assign and do it. Because without resonance you cannot design. Fine. So what is the problem? You need to match 10 plus J10 to 50 ohms. Am I right? 10 plus J10 to 50 ohms. Shall we do it? Right. Upper transformation or downward transformation?
Upper
transformation. Step 1. It is upward transformation. What network will we choose? What network will we choose? C? L. Right. C L network. Listen here. What is R? 10 plus
10.
J10. What is this fellow? 50 ohms. This fellow is 50 ohms. Yes? What is the next step? Step 2 is what? What is RP and RS? What is RP? What is RS? Second person, what is RS? RS is 10. What is RP then? RP is 50. What is Q? Root of RP by RS minus 1. What is it?
2.
2 R. What is 50? 4, yeah. 2. U is?
2.
Are we getting it? What is step 3? What is step 3? Sorry? That one series 2?
Parallel.
Right? So this one will be like this. This one will be what? L? Have a read up. L is in?
Series.
Oh, sorry, it's already in series, huh? Sorry. So this one will be P. P and this A will be LP, okay. 10 plus ZL.
Right? So everybody has become an expert in impedance matching.
So, so this one will be what? 50 ohms. This one will be 50 ohms. What is the next step? What do we need to compute? What do we need to compute?
LP.
LP. What will be LP?
RP
by omega naught U, right? RP by omega naught Q. What is RP?
3.92.
RP is 50 by 1 into 10 power 9. And what is Q up? 3.97 nanohenry. Are we getting it? Are we getting it up?
Yes.
So RP is 3.97 nanohenry. What is the next step? Step 4. Find? Step 4 is what to find? C. How do we find C? C is equal to? 1 by omega naught squared? B. 1 by omega naught squared? LB. What is CB? 6.38 because I'm all beginning it.
Dude, all of you getting it 6.38 picofarad? Yes or no? Yes,
6.38 picofarad. So when we draw the circuit, 6.38 picofarad. What is it? 3.97 nanohenry, and this way is 10, now tell me, plus J test, what does it mean? Inductive load or capacitive load? This is 10 plus J 10, is it inductive or capacitive?
Inductive.
What is the value of this load?
Yes.
Find out what is L? How do you find out L? XL is equal to? Okay, what is XL equal to? Omega into L. What is XL value? 10. Omega is 2 into pi into 1 into 10 power 9 into L. Tell me what is the value of L? Point?
1.5?
1.5 nanofarad, are you sure?
1.5
nanofarad. Are you sure 1.5 nanofarad? Farad. 1.5 nano? Henry. 1.5 nano? Entry. Right? Listen here. Now what is step 6? How do you compute Z? There is an inductive load here. There is an inductive load here. What do I have here? I'll have a inductor in series. So what should I do? Compensate by adding the inductance here. Compensate by adding the inductance here. These two products are in series or in parallel?
Series.
So how will I get the total value? L is equal to L1 plus L2 or L1 L2 by L1 plus L2? L1 plus L2, right? So L is equal to L1 plus L2. What is L1? 3.97 nanometer. What is this fellow? 1.5 nanometer. And what do I get? What do I get? 5.47 nanometer. 5.47 nanometer. Am I right? So this is my inductance value. So if I draw the circuit, it goes like this. 5.47 nanometer. This guy is 6.38 picofarad. Is it okay? This is the impedance matching circuit. This is the impedance matching circuit. You are matching 50 ohms to 10 plus Zn. You are matching 50 ohms with 10 plus Zn. I think last circuit we didn't write that. I think write that value. What did we do? 50 minus Zn. 10 plus Zn. What happened? So W one is okay. 10 plus J 10. This is your impedance matching circuit. These two fellows are our impedance matching circuit. This fellow is 50 ohms, this fellow is, we are not changing these two now. We are trying to connect 50 ohms with 10 plus J 10. So these two values will not change. Carry on. Only these two values we are deciding what will be the value of L and what will be the value of C. Are you all confident with LC circuits? Say yes or no, da?
Yes.
So this is your LC lumped element matching. Lumped element matching. Okay. Make it out of it.